Good Morning Bay Street is a production of theuptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Friday, July 31st, 2009. Well, yesterday was a wild day in the market. We were looking for a breakout or a breakdown from the tight channel the S&P 500 had been in. And we got a breakout to the upside at the open. And basically, after the short covering was done, we didn't go anywhere. The market traded sideways for the rest of the day and sold off into the close when they found out there was no real new buyers yesterday. So what was resistance before now is acting as support for the S&P 500. We didn't make it to 1,000, which I thought we should have been able to do yesterday. We certainly were able to make it to 2,000 on the NASDAQ Composite Index. And similar situation, big pop at the open with all the short covering orders. And basically throughout the rest of the day, nobody came in to take the market higher. And at the end of the day, we had a sell-off. So, it wasn't as bullish a day as people think. The other thing that I saw a lot of on Thursday was gap filling. This is the GLD, the big U.S. Gold ETF. And basically, after the open, we ran up, filled the gap, and traded sideways for the rest of the day, and then sold off into the close. Similar situation for the USO, which is the big U.S. crude oil ETF. It ran up, filled the open gap, and couldn't make any headway after that. So, filling a gap is one thing. What you're really looking for is a breakout above the open gap. And we didn't see a lot of that yesterday. We just saw a lot of gap filling and then selling off after the gap was filled. That in itself is a bearish sign. But, of course, we need to see follow through to the downside on Friday. We're not getting that in the pre-market just before 8 o'clock. But we've got U.S. GDP numbers coming out at 8:30. And that should put some excitement into the futures in the pre-market on Friday. Now, here's what we're looking at. For the TSX, we need a daily close below 10,400 to give us a new daily sell signal for the TSX. The opposite, we need a daily close above 262 for the TSX Energy Index to give us a new buy signal on Friday. For financial stocks, we need a daily close below 164. For gold stocks, we need a daily close above 310 to give us a new daily buy signal. For the venture exchange, we need a daily close below 1115. For the Canadian dollar, we need a daily close below 9030 to give us a sell signal. For gold, we need a daily close above 949 to give us a new buy signal. For crude oil, big up day yesterday, came up, filled the gap. We need a daily close below 65 to give us a new daily sell signal. Natural gas was up sharply on Thursday, but we need to close above 378 to give us a new daily buy signal. Looking at the hourly charts on Friday for the TSX, we'll remain bullish as long as we don't start closing below 10,590. For the energy stocks, we'll remain bullish as long as we don't start closing below 258 on Friday. For financial stocks, we need an hourly close below 171.50 to give us a new intraday sell signal. And for gold stocks, we need an hourly close below 295 to give us an intraday sell signal for the TSX Gold Index. Now, we're closed on Monday. It's a holiday here. We will be making charts Monday night. I can't guarantee that throughout the month of August, but the offices will be closed during trading hours on Mondays in August. So the next time you hear from me is on Tuesday morning. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.